Hello all, welcome back to a new SRR tutorial. Today I'll be telling you how to dock a receptor and a ligand using SRR. That is, how to find whether the ligand which we have with us goes and binds with the receptor or not. Today I'll be showing you an well-known example of aspirin which binds with cyclooxygenase enzyme in humans. So generally we take aspirin when we have a body pain or when we have fever, we generally take aspirin. So what happens with the aspirin is that it goes and binds with the cyclooxygenase enzyme exactly in the serine residues, and when it goes and binds, it becomes an irreversible binding so that the ligand doesn't come out of the receptor. Today this we will be seeing in an in silico method using the computational drug designing. So let's start. For this, first we have to go to Google, and here we need to take the 3D crystal structure of the receptor which we need. So as I told you, today I'll be showing you the example of cyclooxygenase. So let's take the crystal structure of cyclooxygenase. So go to Google, type protein database or PDB. Here you will get RCSP link, click that, go to search bar and type the protein of interest. Today we will be seeing cyclooxygenase. Here when you go inside this page, you get an options of which species you want, what taxonomy, whether you want X-ray crystal structure or NMR resolved structures, what resolution you want, recent crystal structure you want or the older one. So there are some options from which you can choose which suits your particular research criteria. So today I want crystal structure from humans. So I am clicking Homo sapiens, and I want X-ray crystal structure, so X-ray diffraction, and I'll give search. As you can see here in the top, I got the crystal structure of COX-1, which is cyclooxygenase from humans. There will be many other structures when you scroll down. Based on the score you can select, or there are many criteria from which you can choose the exact structure which you need. So today I will be choosing 6Y36 because this is the one which I needed. Click this. See, here you can see it belongs to the classification of oxidoreductase organism from humans, which is Homo sapiens. And if you need more information about this crystal structure, you get the literature also, from which you can go and you can read this paper also. Here you get information about the sequence length, gene name, how many chains are there. And here you get the information about the ligands also. If there are any ligands used, you will get the ligands also. So these are the information that you generally get in protein data bank. So here I just need the crystal structure. So I'll go to download files and click PDB format. I want the crystal structure in the PDB format. So I'll click PDB format. The crystal structure has been downloaded. So now we will open this crystal structure which has been downloaded in the SRA. So I'll go to SRA, file, load. You can even directly take the PDB file from the internet, or you can download it and you can load it again. So since I have downloaded it, I will go to load PDB file. So from wherever you have downloaded and saved it, you can go there. and load your protein. So when you click this icon here, the full structure gets concised and comes in the center. Okay, so if you press F6, you will get the ribbon structure. So this is the crystal structure of cyclooxygenase chain A. So we'll see what are all there in this. This is the entire structure. If you click S or no, you'll get it. This is the entire secondary structure. This is the some compound. We'll check what this compound is. When you click here you can find what it is. I have clicked on the carbon residue, carbon element, so it is showing as carbon, and its residue is NaG2b. It is generally used during the crystallization purpose. So NaG is not needed for us. So you can click here. See, this is the NaG structure. So click here on this molecule B, right click and click delete. The structure will get removed. So generally when performing docking studies, you shouldn't have any other extra cofactors or any other ligands. You just need a clean protein. So next we'll check what is a small c. It's here. So click here. Again, this is NaG, NaG, which we don't need it. So we will delete even this. Delete. So next we'll check what is molecule D. It's in the center here somewhere. I think it's this one. We'll check it again. Yes, it's this one. Even this is NaG. We don't need this. Right click and delete it. We still have three molecules here. We'll just check it out. This is FLC. So we'll check what is FLC in the protein data bank. So here it has been mentioned as FLC is a ligand. If you wish to have this, you can have it, but generally during docking studies we do not need it. So we'll go and delete that one also. For docking, you generally need only the protein 3D structure. Remove other stuff. If needed, you can have the cofactors like metal ions. So let's check what is this. This is also FLC, which is not needed. And this is also FLC. Let me delete it. So this is generally the water molecule. HOH means water molecules. No need of water molecules also. I will delete it. So now you have only the protein structure, secondary structures. Press F6 for ribbon model. And now you need to save this one for the further studies. So go to File, Save As, PDB file. Select the sequence, click OK, and select the place where you wanted to save this. I will save it in SRA as same PDB ID, or you can rename it also. Since this is COX1, I will rename it as COX1 receptor. Whenever you are using a PDB structure for docking, if it is a receptor, you need to write it as receptor.pdb. If it is a ligand, you need to mention it as ligand.pdb. Okay, so I'll save it. format is PDB format. Click OK. The file will get saved. So let's check whether the file has been saved or not. Here you can see the file has been saved, COX1. So I will clean this page. This is the clean icon. Press here to clean the page. It will get cleaned. Or if not, you can go to file and click new. Yes, so that you will have a new page. Then go to load PDB file. I have saved it here. Go to the folder wherever you have saved and click it. Click F6. So now we will do energy minimization of this protein. Whenever you are retrieving a ligand or a receptor from the database, you need to energy minimize it. So go to options, choose file, energy minimization. If you want to know more information about this energy minimization, I have already posted a video. I'll give the link in the description. Please check it out. So now energy minimization is happening. It will take few seconds. This energy minimization depends on the size of the protein. If your protein is a bit bigger, it takes much more time. Wait till this message box disappears. When it disappears, it means that energy minimization is completed. Now you can see the energy is getting minimized. You can see some changes that has been taking place in this secondary structure of the protein. We are doing energy minimization because during crystallization there will be some external pressure or force that has been applied onto the protein. So just to remove all those hindrance, we are doing energy minimization. Now you can see the message box has disappeared. Press space. And you can get how much is the final energy of this protein. Here you can see it's -20,529 kilojoule per mole. Now you need to save this so that you can use it for further procedures like docking or simulation. Go to file, save as, PDB, COX1 receptor, click OK. And I'm going to save it with the same name. I'll click OK. Since I am overwriting it, I'll click S. So now it has been saved. Now you need to retrieve the ligand. To retrieve the ligand, again go to Google. Go to PubChem database. There are many other databases, you can choose anything. I want to check how aspirin goes and binds with COX1. So I will write aspirin here. So I got aspirin, click this. Go to download. If you get a 3D confirmer, it's better to take the 3D confirmer. I have the 3D confirmer, so I'm downloading this. Save as SGF format. Save. So I'll go to SRA now. I will clean the receptor. Let's load SGF file here, which is the ligand file. Other file format, format is SGF. So you need to click SGF here. Click SGF MDmol, and from whichever folder you have taken, go there. So this is the file. So I'll just click on this file and click OK. So you will get the ligand here. So every time whenever you use a ligand that has been downloaded or retrieved from the database, you need to energy minimize it. So first load the ligand, go to options, go to choose experiment, energy minimization. Energy minimization is going on. So once the energy minimization is over, this line will disappear. So the line has got disappeared. Press space, you'll get to know whether it has done or not. Here you can see energy minimization is completed. The final energy is minus 200 kilojoule per mole. So now you have to save this. So go to file, save as. You have to save it in SGF format. So since there is no SGF here, you need to go to, other file format. Click the object and click the format. Format is SGF. Ligand format should be as SGF and receptor format should be as .pdb. Do not forget it. This is SGF and I will save it in the folder where I have already saved the receptor. Always remember to save the receptor and ligand in the same folder. Do not change it. So this I will save it as COX-1 ligand. Remember the name that has been given in the front before this ligand or the receptor. It should be same for both ligand and receptor. You can remember I have saved the receptor as COX-1-PDB. So the same thing I am saving it for ligand also. This is COX-1-ligand.sgf. Remember that you should save it in the same file. So now it's time for us to do docking. So clean this. If you want, you can just click new and yes. So now I'll tell you how to do docking. See here, you can see I have both the receptor and the ligand in the same file. If you want, you can put this in a separate new file also. I'll show it in a new file. Remember, it's very important to put it like this, underscore ligand.sgf for ligand and underscore receptor.pdb for the protein, which is the receptor. So now I have both ligand and receptor in the same file. So come to SRA. Now for docking, you need to go to options, macro and movie, set target. Every time when you choose an experiment, you need to give the target where the files are located. So go to set target. Here go to the file location and click, first you have to click the receptor. So click receptor. See what they have mentioned here, remove file extension. So you should remove the file extension here. So you just need to remove this underscore receptor.pdb. You just need to delete that. Underscore receptor.pdb should be removed as they have mentioned, remove the file extension. So then click OK. Now go to options, macros and movies. Go to play macro. So when you come to Play Macro, here you can see there are many files named as .mcr, .mcr. You have to do docking now. So you just need to click doc run .mcr. Here you can see I have two doc run files. One is doc run.mcr, the other is doc run _100.mcr. The 100 here which I meant is this software will dock the ligand in 100 different possible positions to get the best possible results for us. So generally in the software it takes only 8 runs. 8 runs means it will do it 8 times. If you want more precise result, then you can go for a higher number of runs. So as I have mentioned here I have made it as 100 runs. So this I'll just run it for 8 runs so that it will give the result in a fraction of seconds. I'll click doc run dot mcr and click OK. So why I have told you that you need to place the receptor and ligand in the same file is that when here we have just mentioned the set target as the receptor. We have given the pathway only for the receptor. What happens is that the software automatically takes the ligand from the specified file and it starts running its program. So I'll show you once the program is done. See, now the work is in progress. Totally 25 runs it has been taken by the software. So number of runs, how much ever you want, you can set it. If you want 25, you can use the normal programmed thing. Or else if you want a more run, you can edit it in the MCR file. I'll show you in another video how to edit it in the MCR file based on the number of runs we need. So let's wait till the progress gets completed. So here it will be shown as 25 of 25 runs completed. Then it means the program has been run and the file has been generated. The generated file we can analyze later. Once the docking has been completed, the line which appeared before here, it will get disappeared. And also you can go to the file where you have saved your receptor and ligand. And there you can see you will get a log file there, which means the process has been completed and the results have been obtained. So here you can go click this button so that it will come to the center. Click F6 to have a clear visibility. See, now you can see the aspirin has got bounded in these many places, here. So there are many places where the aspirin has got bound with the receptor. So but we need to find the best one. So how to find the best one? The best one is generally based on its binding energy, binding efficiency, based on its interaction with the receptor. So we'll go and check the log file now. So here is the log file. This is a global docking result which we have done. We haven't specified a particular area in which only there it has to go and bind. So if we are specifying a particular area where the ligand should go and bind, then it is called as local docking. Here we haven't mentioned any particular site where it should go and bind. If you have a previous literature telling the compound should bind only in this particular area between some two alpha helixes or some between some loops, there is some particular area and you have the active site residues, then you can map those active site residues and then you can do the docking in a similar way. I'll show you in the next video how to mark the active site and do the docking studies. So this we performed the global docking studies. So here you have got the result. So the highest binding energy, as you can see here, is 6.588 kilocalorie per mole and the lowest one is 4.297. So you can also see there are residues which binds with the receptor. So the ligand binds with alanine and all these residues and all. So these residues interaction is very important for your binding studies. So you can see below what are all the dissociation constant with the
all these runs. So totally there were 25 runs as we saw earlier, and we will here we will take the best one, which is the first one, which was 6.588. So I'll just open and show you this first one. So go to the folder, and here this is the first one. You will get the results in these ways. See, only these two we need to put it in the folder. Rest all from here till all these things will be generated by the software itself. You don't need to worry about all these things. It will directly put it in the folder where you are working, in your work directory it will put it. So we will open this one and we will see. I'm opening it in Asana. So this is the best structure which we got after docking studies. I'll press F6 for a clear view of ribbon structure. F6. See, here you can see where the ligand has gone and bound. So here is the ligand. You can zoom in. And you can see the nearby residues also. Suppose if you are clicking it here, you will get a rotating kind of stuff, loading kind of stuff, and then you can see the element and its residue number also. See, the residue is GLN203. So here this side in the loop, this is histidine 443. So you can actually see like this also. In the next video I'll tell you more about these, how to view it in PyMOL or other discovery studios. I'll show you how to see the interaction and all. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share the video to your friends also, and let them also get the knowledge about docking studies and especially using SR. Thank you. See you in the next video. Bye.